Hey guys, how are you? Hope you had a wonderful weekend. So we're going to talk about Chelsea Handler. I know that seems like kind of a petty topic, but we did talk about 50 Cent last week. So this kind of goes into that. Also, this mentality and this sort of sentiment that she has and things that she says, this is pretty common among people that think like her. I'm not going to say all Democrats. That's not true. There are a lot of moderate Democrats that don't agree with the things that she says. These just happen to be the loudest and most obnoxious. And this is one of the sentiments that pushed me to be a Republican. And I can't remember if I spoke about Chelsea Handler specifically on my walk away video, but at the time that I made that switch, I was a huge Chelsea Handler fan. I watched her show religiously on Netflix. I've been to her tapings. Big fan. I even followed her when she was on Girls Behaving Badly. But hearing her continually talk about politics and just push me completely to the other side. And you're going to see why in just a second. So we'll get into that, what happened with Chelsea Handler over the weekend and her response to 50 Cent sort of pseudo endorsing Donald Trump because of the tax rates. And then I'm going to sort of drive home one of my points with Gene Simmons unexpectedly. But first, I read something really interesting over the weekend. This is another reason I want to talk about this. So I'm going to read you a few excerpts from this book, and then we will look at some footage of Chelsea. So this book, it's actually one of my favorite books. It's called Thick Face, Black Heart, written by Chin Ning Chu. And it came out in 1992, but I was pretty shocked at some of the things that she talked about in this book. So she goes into virtue signaling and victimization. So we'll get into that. I'm going to read you a few of the things that she wrote in this book. So she's talking about virtue signaling and how virtue can sometimes be a force for evil without us realizing it. So she says, the limited human wisdom that guides our concept of virtue often becomes our compelling force for evil. Our false concept of virtue often is nothing but vanity in an attempt to gain praise or be self-righteous about how virtuous we are, so we may feel superior to others. So many times because this false virtue is accompanied by a dose of human ignorance, virtue becomes an effective weapon in making humanity a victim. And then it starts talking about victimization. When it comes to the victimization of humanity under the banner of virtue, there is no division of East, West, past or present. So I'll read you one more little paragraph and then we'll get into it. Today, virtuous citizens with sincere intentions attempt to impose their standards and moral codes regarding many social issues onto others in the name of goodness and decency. The question we have to ask ourselves is, can we be so sure that our concept of virtue has not become a compelling force for hatred, intolerance, and hypocrisy? Are we not once more victimizing humanity? Virtue, contrary to what most people think, is not something that you wear outside of yourself for public display. Okay. So let's watch a clip from Chelsea Handler on Jimmy Fallon. This, I believe, was aired Friday night.
Go.
You heard about my ex-boyfriend, right? 50 Cent and his support of Donald Trump.
Yeah, what's going on between you? I saw your tweets and I go, wait, what's happening? Because you said he was your favorite ex-boyfriend and then he, what does he do? He's supporting Trump?
He says he doesn't want to pay 62% of taxes, which, by the way, isn't a plan of Joe Biden's. That's a lie. So he doesn't want to pay 62% of taxes because he doesn't want to go from being 50 cent to 20 cent. And I had to remind him that he was a black person, so he can't vote for Donald Trump, and that he shouldn't be influencing an entire swath of people who may listen to him because he's worried about his own personal pocketbook. So I haven't heard back from him yet, but I am willing to, you know, seal the deal in more ways than one if he changes his mind and publicly denounces Donald Trump. I might be willing to go for another spin, if you know.
Okay, there's a lot to unpack there. Well, first, Chelsea Handler is wrong about the taxes. So 50 Cent was referring to the 62% tax rate that he would have to pay. He is someone that makes over $400,000 a year or has a net worth over $400,000. And Joe Biden and Kamala Harris have said, I don't know how many times on their campaign, that's what they're going to do. And that's how they're going to pay for things like healthcare and this and that that they're promising. They are going to raise taxes on anyone that makes over $400,000 a year. They have said this We are going to raise taxes on those that make over $400,000 a year, and that's how they are going to pay for some of these things that they're proposing. Also, Kamala Harris, even Joe Biden has said it too, but I'll give a specific example. In the VP debates, Kamala Harris said that one of the first things they're going to do when they get in office is repeal the Trump tax cuts. The Trump tax cuts for lower-income Americans, for middle-class Americans, put thousands of dollars per year in the pocket of those people, of millions of Americans all over the U.S. And that's one of the first things they're going to do is get rid of that. What is that going to do? It's going to raise taxes. So yes, they are in fact going to raise your taxes. And especially when you're promising things like they want to do the Green New Deal, which is their version of the Green New Deal and this and that. It costs a lot of money. Where do you think they're going to get that money? They have to raise taxes in order to get that money. So she's wrong there. And then obviously the most disturbing part of that whole conversation is her saying, I don't know if 50 Cent knows he's not black. And a lot of Republicans criticized her saying that that in fact was racist. And we talk about this a lot on the channel, this channel. I don't like it when people just throw around that term because it's just been weaponized and used to silence people. But I don't know what else this is. Saying because someone is a certain color, that they have to think a certain way just because you think that way and because you think it's right. I don't know what else that is. The only way I get this being a female. People tell me, how can you be a woman and vote for Donald Trump? Because I have a brain and because I think for myself and because I'm not a sheep to the mainstream media like you are, and I actually look at policies and I actually look at what's being done and I look at the actions that have been taken, and I'm sorry, I don't see it. The mainstream media wants you to think that because they don't want you to like him. They don't want you to know the good that he's doing for the country. So I would imagine having an ex-boyfriend publicly talking about me with another man saying that I must not know I'm a woman because I'm voting for Donald Trump. I mean, that's just so offensive and so ignorant. And Donald Trump supporters, they are a very, very diverse group of people, and they don't agree with you. And that doesn't mean that they're wrong. But a lot of Republicans came out and said that this was very racist, what she said. And I want to show you her reaction to this, and we'll talk about that too. So this was posted to Chelsea Handler's Instagram stories. She must have posted it yesterday or this morning. It's still up right now, so take a look at this.
All these comments from these Trump supporters telling me I'm a racist. And I would like to remind you that you are supporting a president who refuses to utter the sentence, Black Lives Matter. That's who you support. So you better believe I'm going to reach out to my ex-boyfriend when I find out that he says he's supporting that guy. You better believe I'm going to try to get a better understanding of how we could possibly think that we could vote for somebody who refuses to say the sentence Black Lives Matter.
You know, the more and more I meet Trump supporters, the more and more I watch footage from the rallies, or I talk to people, or I talk to you guys on this channel, or I watch other commentators, the more and more ignorant that sounds, or people like this sound, because there's a lot of people that are critical of BLM. And one thing that there's a lot of Black people, Asian people, Hispanic people, gay, trans, white, male, female, that are critical of the organization BLM. And I'll tell you why. And what Chelsea Handler doesn't seem to understand is that BLM is an organization. So you can be behind the sentiment. Of course, we all think Black Lives Matter. Of course, police brutality is real. Of course, we were all appalled by the killing of George Floyd. Of course, a lot of us think that there should be police reform. Of course, and police officers should be held accountable. But the reason why Donald Trump doesn't support BLM, and the reason why a lot of people are critical of BLM, is because that is an organization. And let's talk about the organization of BLM for just a second. First of all, the organizers of BLM are self-admitted, they've said this on tape several times, they're self-admitted Marxists. They have a political agenda. They've said this from the beginning. On their website, which was recently removed, they wanted to break down the family unit and basically Western civilization and create this whole new thing. That is what it says on the website, or what it said on the website of BLM. They had to remove it because they got so much criticism for it. Also, BLM, they've had $1 billion in donations. Where's that money gone? Have they built schools or centers, or have they put that back into the very communities that they say they're helping? No, nobody knows where that money has gone. $1 billion, where is it gone? Also, since the killing of George Floyd, the support of BLM has gone down like 38%, because if you look beyond the surface, if you look what's going on in these protests or riots, more people have died in the protests at the hands of other demonstrators than police killed all of last year. So that's why people don't support that. There's been billions of dollars in property damage. And the very people that will get on their social media and say, go support a black business, do you think any of them donated to any of the black businesses that were burned down in the riot? Because there were a lot. There were a lot of white, but there were a lot of businesses that were burned down, including a lot of black businesses, which I find ironic since we're there for Black Lives Matter. Yet they're burning down black businesses. Black people have died. White people have died too. We're just talking about color because this is for Black Lives Matter. So this is why people are critical of Black Lives Matter. That is an organization. Two things can be true at once. I know it's hard to think in nuance, and it's hard to, and I know some people just want to think in black and white. Another reason why people are critical of the organization BLM, and I am in no way excusing any officer for using excessive force. We all know that's wrong. But compliance also has to be a part of the conversation. You know, I've always been taught if a police officer does anything wrong when you're encountering a police officer, just do what you need to do, comply, take down the badge number, and then take care of it the right way. And when we keep demonizing police officers to these young boys, and I'm talking about all boys in general, not just a certain race, but all boys, boys are just more likely to resist arrest or not be compliant with police officers. But when we keep demonizing police officers without having compliance be a part of the conversation, we're basically just encouraging more boys, or creating an environment where more young boys are going to resist arrest, are going to put up a fight, and are going to create this environment where things like this are more likely to happen. So we're sitting here saying we care about these people, but that's not even a part of the conversation. And in an odd way, we're kind of setting them up. And again, you know what? You might not agree with me, and that's okay. You cannot agree with me. That's the beauty of America. You can disagree with me, and I'm not going to tell you that you're dumb, or that you don't know what you're talking about, or I'm not going to tell you that you are betraying your race or betraying your gender just because you don't agree with me. And because we live in America, and that's the beauty of it. We can criticize things and still get along and still live here. Well, that was quite a tangent, and I apologize, but now I'm going to circle back, and then we'll be finished with this. We're going to talk about taxes for just a minute, because this just came out on therealnews.com. I will link to the article below if you want to read it. But this is about, this is Gene Simmons talking about why him and his wife are selling their Beverly Hills home. And this is why taxes are important, and keeping taxes low for corporations, for your 1%, for business owners. This is why keeping regulations and taxes low is important, because of this. So Gene Simmons explained why he was moving right here. California and Beverly Hills have been treating folks that create jobs badly, and the tax rates are unacceptable. I work hard and pay my taxes, and I don't want to cry the Beverly Hills blues, but enough is enough. And this is exactly what happens. When you raise taxes on corporations and businesses and you're wealthy, they will pick up and move somewhere else that is nicer to them. And Chelsea Handler should know this. She's an actress. She's a comedian. That's why things are being filmed in Vancouver and Atlanta and Louisiana and New Mexico. That's why those markets are thriving, because it's cheaper to film in Vancouver and make it look like New York City rather than filming in New York City. It's cheaper to film in Louisiana or Atlanta and make it look like LA or anywhere else, because the tax incentives are much better. And when you take your business and move it elsewhere, you're also taking jobs. And this is why Trump lowering taxes for corporations was so important, because those corporations who were going to other countries because it was cheaper to have their business there and easier are now coming back to the U.S., creating jobs for people. Our 1%, you want to keep their taxes at a decent rate, because they pay 50% of your income taxes in California and in New York City. And we're already seeing a mass exodus out of California. Charles Schwab is leaving California. How many jobs are under Charles Schwab? So Charles Schwab and all of those jobs are out. They're leaving California. The Daily Wire left California. That's Ben Shapiro's company. 75 jobs. They up and left and went to, they went to Nashville. Both companies left because of taxes and regulations. It's just making it impossible. Joe Rogan just took his podcast. Now he's in Austin, Texas. Elon Musk was talking about bringing, pulling Tesla out of California. Taxes, the lockdowns and all of that. That's the last car manufacturer that will be in California. And here you have, Gene Simmons talking about the taxes too, about how he's leaving. I have friends that are being advised by their financial advisors to leave California because it just doesn't make sense financially to live here. And what's going to happen to the people that can't afford to leave? They are going to be stuck here. They're going to have to raise taxes on someone. If people that are paying 50% of your income taxes are leaving, they're going to have to raise it on someone. So what's going to happen? That's all I have to say about that. Sorry, I went off on 25 tangents. Let me know what you guys think. Have a wonderful day. Goodbye.